after 25 years we need to do it again. But we played it pretty well then, so we'll have to mind our pitch. So, just the top, please.
Any good thing that comes to an end, there's a bittersweet aspect to it. But in this particular case, and for me, is a sense of real pleasure in having been able and given the opportunity and the energy to complete this whole picture. I feel very lucky and very happy about it. It's not something we planned. We didn't set out to stay together all that time. It's just in retrospect, it's kind of like a good marriage. You look back at it after all those years and say, wow, we really made it.
It's not on here, it's not on there. I think you forgot to put the title on it. Since I was right, can I name that cue?
I wonder if it's actually true that there was not a title on the cue.
You saved it just for me.
There's no question in my mind, for George, the single biggest collaborator that he has is John. George always has the idea of what the music is going to do.
You say the focus is on really the emotional content, not on the bombastic of it.
Music is the complete and utter support system for the way in which he tells his stories.
They probably demand more music than any other films in terms of quantity than any films that I know. It makes it very difficult, but it also makes it a great opportunity. It's a great place for a composer to have a free swing with the bat, so to speak.
Film, you go to listen to the score for the first time with a certain amount of trepidation and anxiety because you never know exactly what you're going to hear. For us, it's the complete opposite. We cannot wait till we get to London. We cannot wait to hear it because there's never any issue, is this going to work with John? You always know it's going to work, and you know it's going to work beyond anything that you ever expected.
London Symphony, which we call the LSO, affectionately, has been with us all these years. And the orchestra's recorded the scores for all six of the films now, which is a point of pride not only for me, but also for the orchestra itself. And I think George, in general, and at the moment of the creation of the music, he's alert to getting things right for his story, but I think he enjoys the experience and appreciates the experience on the level just of having great musicians perform for his film.
There's no doubt George has the greatest respect for John and the LSO. It's been the most wonderful collaboration and partnership in film history, I think, in terms of the set of the Star Wars saga. One of the things I'm really excited about is there's a music video that's been made. It's 70 minutes long.
This DVD that's going to be presented allows us to tell the whole story musically for all six episodes with all the principal themes so that people can hear the whole story musically, which I don't think has ever been quite done just like that before.
It almost makes watching Star Wars as like a silent film. You can watch it without any dialogue and totally understand the emotional apex of what's going on simply by John's music.
Yeah,
I think we can do that.
So we do it.
Okay.
Revenge of the Sith, certainly I would agree that it is the darkest one of all of them. Does that mean that it's the darkest music? You can be looking at something that's quite horrific, but the music can be giving you a sense of compassion rather than just simply underlying what's very dark and difficult about it. So that when you separate the music out, the listener might decide it's not the darkest music. It may not be.
It may be a thought, something useful to say, people don't, when you have crescendi in a piece that's consistently loud like this, Don't make too much of an effort to get louder. Don't play the nuance mark so much. Be more interested in the note and the pitch. Okay, Sean.
Has it been a fun score to write? Yes, it's fun, but I think it's more accurate to say that it's endlessly compelling.